each other. Let's take it from there. And if I could, I'd love you up forever and time. Oh, what we've been through, no one else knows. 'Cause all that matters is how far this goes. And it will go until it starts again.
commit the vows of God and giving to you. They have symbolized their vows by giving and receiving rings. And I now pronounce that they are husband and wife.
Wow.
Those who God has joined together, let no one separate. You may now kiss your bride, Jason. I'm hot too. Okay.
Sunshine, she's here. You can take a break.
I'd love you forever and time. Oh, oh, oh. What we've been through, no one else knows. Cause all that matters is how far this goes. And it'll all go until it starts again. Oh, oh. And you are built like armor. Nothing can stop love.
Always put God first in your life and have fun.
So we honor you for being married for so long, and you have more years of being a bride, and that's more important.
But one day the sun will shine through.
My brother Jason got married, man.
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah, I did.
Me too.
Man, that's great.
Hey, here I am.
All right, Adrian, we did it. You know, we're married now. I got my ring on. Look forward to the future with you. Building a family, procreating, like we always talk about. And just, you know, you have been a blessing to me. I'm trying to be a blessing to you. And we're in for the long haul. This is it. Today is our day, June 27, 2015. And I love you.
Well, Jason, you are my best friend and the best friend I've ever had in my entire life. And you are in for great meals and a lot of fun and lots of babies and lots of laughs. And I'm so excited about having siblings now that I'm with you. This is just a fabulous relationship.
You're on.
First, giving thanks and honor to God, I am happy to send my love and best wishes to my granddaughter, Adrian, and her husband, Jason. I might not be there in body, but I'm here in spirit. I am happy, and I might not be, I'm happy, okay, but I'm here in spirit. I know you will be happy together with long life as long as you give me God first. So so stay happy and loving always. Love. Granddaddy.
Okay. Hello, baby girl. How are you? Your grandma's favorite girl. I was so happy the day you were born. I danced a jig and still dancing a jig because now you're carrying out all my wishes. And I always wanted you to be the fine young lady that you are. And now you're getting married to a nice young man. Jason is very handsome and nice and kind, and it was such a pleasure to meet him. I would love to be there. If I had $1 million and they could fly me through the sky, I'd pay $1 million to be there. But thanks be to God, Grandma's not the same anymore. And I had my 82nd birthday in January, so the doctor advised me not to travel anymore. And other than that, I'd come, but I thought if I go against the doctor's wishes, and anything would happen to me, then you'd probably deal with that. And I love you too much to have you living with any guilt about anything concerning me. Jason is fantastic. I know you're going to be one of the happiest ladies in the world. The Lord meant that for you the day you were born. You were 6 weeks old, and I pat you on your back, and you pat me on my back. I knew then you were my angel from heaven, and I love you. You're the sweetest young lady I've ever known. You have so much going for you. You've done so many wonderful things to make me very proud of you, and I'm so happy and thankful. Lord, since you're a good mate, I claimed it, and I know it's going to be just perfect. But I wouldn't put any kind of damage or edge onto your celebration. And I do believe that the trip is probably too much for me. That's what the doctor said. I had my 82nd birthday, January 5th. Love you, love you, love you. Have a wonderful life that I know the Lord has already destined for you. And I'm sure everything will be just perfect. Just like as if I was there and I claimed it. I pray a lot for you and I love you. Love you, you know I always did and always will and always have. Love you, Grandma.